ओके स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास 12th मैथमेटिक्स सीबीएसई। सो फार वी हैव लर्नड मोर अबाउट द वेक्टर एलजेब्रा। ओके, वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्नड व्हाट डज मीन बाय द वेक्टर्स स्केलर्स, व्हाट डज मीन बाय द डायरेक्शन कोसाइन एंड हाउ टू फाइंड द कंपोनेंट ऑफ ए वेक्टर एंड हाउ टू फाइंड द कंपोनेंट ऑफ ए वेक्टर व्हेन द एंड पॉइंट्स ऑफ a line segment are given, how to find the magnitude of a vector and the addition of two vectors. Okay, we have already learned about the two laws of addition of vectors, that is parallelogram law of addition of vectors and as well as the triangular law of addition of vectors. We have already learned all about these. Okay, the parallelogram law of vector states that if a vector and b vector are any two vector and are representing any two adjacent sides with the same initial point in magnitude and direction, then the sum of these two vector will be represented by the diagonal of that parallelogram. Okay, diagonal of that parallelogram with same initial point. Okay, this is the law of parallelogram of addition of two vectors. Okay, and unless and until two vectors follow the parallelogram law of addition of vectors, they are not to be treated as the vectors. Okay, so this is the third condition on vectors to be treated as vector. Okay, and then we have learned about the triangular law of addition of two vectors. In triangular law of addition of two vectors, if a vector and b vector are any two sides in the same direction, taken in the same order, a vector and b vector are any two sides taken in the same direction or same in the same order, then their sum, that is a vector plus b vector, is represented by the third side taken in reverse order. Okay, so these are the two laws that we have already learnt about the addition of vectors and subtraction of vector. Subtraction of vector is again the addition of a vector and negative of a vector. Okay, subtraction is not an algebraic operation in a vector algebra, but subtraction of vector means the addition of vectors, addition of a vector and addition of two vectors, one vector and the negative of another vector, means a vector and minus b vector. Addition of a vector and minus b vector is to be treated as the subtraction of vector. Okay, so subtraction of vector also means the addition of vectors. So we have already learnt about all these. Today we will learn about the different properties of addition of vectors. Okay, so let's start with the property of addition of vectors. Property of addition of vectors. Okay, first of all, commutative property of addition of vector. Commutative property means a vector plus b vector is equals to b vector plus a vector, and the addition of vectors follows the commutative property also. Okay, means a vector plus b vector is equals to b vector plus a vector actually. Okay, means a vector plus b vector is equals to b vector plus a vector. We have explanation of this. Suppose this is a vector and this is b vector. Okay, we are forming a parallelogram using a vector and b vector. So these are the parallel sides of a vector. This is a vector and this is parallel side of this B vector, that is B vector. Okay. Now this diagonal, sum of these two vectors is represented by this diagonal, that is O, A, B and C. O C vector. So this is C vector, and C vector is equal to A vector plus B vector. Okay. Now we will find again this OC vector using B vector and A vector. Okay. So OC vector is equals to, this is again equals to, now OC vector is equals to OB vector plus BC vector. Okay. So OC vector is equals to B vector, OB vector, that is B vector, plus BC vector, that is A vector. So OC vector is equals to B vector plus A vector, and in this triangle OC vector is equals to OA vector plus AC vector. OA vector means A vector plus AC vector means AC vector means B vector. Okay. So both are OC vector. So OC vector means B vector plus A vector is equals to A vector plus B vector. Okay. This is the commutative property of addition of two vectors. Okay. So the vector addition follows the commutative property. Okay. Now the next property of addition of vectors, that is associative property. The vector addition follows the associative property. Vector addition also follows the associative property. Vector addition follows the associative property. Vector addition follows the associative property that A vector, B vector and C vector be any three vectors, then A vector plus B vector plus C vector is equals to A vector plus B vector plus C vector. Okay. Means we can change the grouping of addition of two vectors. Even then, addition of three vectors will be same. That is the associative property. Okay. Associative property also gives the idea to add three vectors without using the grouping. Means we can add three vectors without making any grouping, that is A vector plus B vector plus C vector, means this is also equals to A vector plus B vector plus C vector. So here in associative property we got the idea about the addition of two or more than two vectors means three vector, four vector, five vector can be added without making any group. Okay. So this is the associative property. Now it comes the additive identity. Additive identity or the identity for addition of vectors. Third property, that is identity for addition of vectors. Okay. Let zero vector be any vector and A vector be also a vector. Okay. Then A vector plus zero vector is equals to zero vector plus A vector. Okay. Zero vector. If we add zero vector in any vector, we will get the vector itself. Okay. Means definition of identity says that when we add any vector, with identity we got the vector itself. Okay, so a vector plus 0 vector is equals to a vector, that is equals to 0 vector plus a vector. So 0 vector is the 0 vector, addition of 0 vector does not make change any, does not make any change in the given vector. That is why 0 vector is the additive identity of the addition of vectors. Okay, so 0 vector is the additive identity for addition of vectors. Okay, so identity for addition of vector is the 0 vector. Now the additive inverse. Whenever we are talking about the addition of vectors, it means we are talking about the additive inverse. So additive inverse of addition of vectors, that is, let a vector be any vector and x vector be its additive inverse. Okay, then a vector plus x vector is equals to 0 vector. Definition of additive inverse says that the addition of two vectors is equals to the additive identity, that is 0 vector. So it is equals to 0 vector. So now adding minus a vector on both the sides. Okay, so minus a vector plus a vector plus x vector is equals to 0 vector plus minus a vector is equals to 0 vector plus x vector is equals to minus a vector, that is x vector is equals to minus a vector. Okay, so additive identity of any vector a vector is minus a vector. Okay, minus a vector is the additive identity. Okay, so these are the four properties of addition of vector. Now the multiplication of a vector with any scalar. Okay, so next topic in vector algebra of part third, that is scalar multiplication of a vector or multiplication of a vector with scalar multiplication. Okay, means when we multiply a given vector with any scalar, means we are multiplying lambda with a vector, that is lambda a vector, then direction does not change. In this case direction does not change, but what is change is the magnitude of the vector, means magnitude of vector becomes lambda times plus lambda times or modulus lambda times of the magnitude of the given vector. Okay, means let us learn here, if a vector is any vector and we want to multiply lambda is any scalar and a vector is any vector. Okay, then we are multiplying lambda with a vector, so lambda a vector is the scalar multiplication vector obtained after scalar multiplication of vector a. Okay, now lambda a vector having the direction or direction depend on the value of lambda. If lambda is positive, then lambda a vector having the same direction edge of a vector. Okay, if lambda is positive, then lambda a vector having the same direction edge of a vector. But if lambda is equals to negative, then lambda a vector having the opposite direction as of a vector. Okay, so this is all about the direction after scalar multiplication of a vector. Okay, now the magnitude of lambda a vector is equals to magnitude of lambda magnitude of a vector. Okay, so magnitude of lambda a vector is the magnitude lambda times of the magnitude of given vector. Okay, so it is lambda times of magnitude of given vector. Okay, so in this way we can explain the scalar multiplication of any vector. Okay, this is an important topic as we can change the direction and we can change the magnitude also by the scalar multiplication of any vector. Okay, means we can change the direction, means we can make the direction opposite by multiplying negative lambda, or we can increase or we can decrease the magnitude of the given vector by multiplying lambda, okay, greater than 1 and less than 1. If lambda is greater than 1, then magnitude will increase. Okay, if lambda is less than 1, then magnitude will decrease. Okay, so we can change the direction and we can also change the magnitude by scalar multiplication, by the property of vectors, that is scalar multiplication. Okay, so this is all about the scalar multiplication of any vector. Now the property of scalar multiplication. Write down the next topic, that is properties of scalar multiplication. Properties of scalar multiplication. Properties of scalar multiplication. Okay. So first property is lambda a vector is equals to lambda a vector. Okay. Lambda a vector is equals to lambda into a vector. And second property is lambda into mu. Lambda into mu. Let us take m or n. Mn into a vector is equals to m into n a vector is equals to n into n a vector. Okay. Third property is m plus n a vector is equals to n a vector plus n a vector. Okay, distributive property. This is distributive property in multiplication. This is distributive property in addition. Okay, then next one is a vector plus b vector multiply m equals to m a vector plus m b vector. Okay, so these are some of the property of scalar multiplication. Okay, now it is the turn of section formula. Plays an important role. Okay, section formula also plays an important role to find the coordinate or to find the position vector of any point inside the line segment or outside the line segment. Means when a point internally or externally divide a line segment, we can find the position vector of that point using the internal section and external section formula. Okay, so now we will discuss about the section formula. सो सेक्शन फॉर्मूला, सेक्शन फॉर्मूला, सेक्शन फॉर्मूला, ओके, दिस इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, सेक्शन फॉर्मूला. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस टेक द इंटरनल सेक्शन फॉर्मूला. इंटरनल सेक्शन, इंटरनल सेक्शन एज द नेम इज इंडिकेटिंग, एज द नेम इज इंडिकेटिंग, इंटरनल सेक्शन इंटरनली डिवाइड ए लाइन सेगमेंट. लेट ए बी इज एनी लाइन सेगमेंट, ए बी इज एनी लाइन सेगमेंट, एंड सी, सी इज एनी पॉइंट इनसाइड द लाइन सेगमेंट. ओके, नाउ लेट ओ बी द ओरिजिन, ओ बी द ओरिजिन, एंड पोजिशन वेक्टर ऑफ ओ विद रेस्पेक्ट टू द ओरिजिन दैट इज ए वेक्टर, पोजिशन वेक्टर ऑफ बी विद रेस्पेक्ट टू द ओरिजिन दैट इज बी वेक्टर, ओके, एंड पोजिशन वेक्टर ऑफ सी विद रेस्पेक्ट टू द ओ दैट इज सी वेक्टर, एंड सी, सी इज डिवाइडिंग ए बी इन द रेशियो एम एंड एन, सी इज डिवाइडिंग ए बी इन द रेशियो एम एंड एन. ओके, नाउ नाउ AC upon BC is equals to AC upon CB is equals to M upon N. So AC upon CB is equals to M upon N. That is AC vector upon CB vector is equals to M upon N. Okay. Now AC vector means position vector of C. C vector minus position vector of A, A vector upon position vector of B minus position vector of C is equals to M upon N. So multiplying M with B vector minus C vector, multiplying M C vector minus A vector is equals to, now simplifying this, M B vector minus M C vector is equals to M C vector minus M A vector. Okay, now MB vector plus, now we want to find the C vector, position vector of C, that is C vector. Okay, so transfer the terms like this, MB vector plus MA vector is equals to MC vector plus NC vector. Now MB vector plus MA vector is equals to, taking C vector as common, M plus M C vector. Okay, so C vector is equals to MB vector plus MA vector and divided by M plus M. Okay, so when the point C is internally divided the line segment AB, line segment AB having the position vector A vector and B vector, then the position vector of C, that is C vector, will be given by C vector is equals to MB vector plus MA vector, MB vector plus MA vector, opposite, we will multiply opposite, that is MB vector plus MA vector divided by M plus M. Okay, so this is the formula for internally, when a point internally divide the given line segment. Okay, so this is the internal section formula. We will draw the formula for external section, and external section the point of division, point of section is outside the line segment, that is, let the diagram will be seen like this. This is that this is A, this is B, and this is C. Okay, this point is A, this point is B. AB is the line segment, AB is the line segment, and this point C, C externally dividing the line segment AB. Externally divided by means this point C will not lie on AB. This point C will not lie AB. This will lie outside the line segment, but in the same line. But in the same line means outside the line segment AB, but in the same line. Okay, means all the three points A, B and C will be collinear points. A, B, C will be collinear point. In that case, we can find the external section formula. Okay. Now, let this is M or M or this is M. This is M. Okay. This is the ratio in which the point C is dividing the line segment AB. Okay. So AC upon BC is equals to N upon M. AC upon BC is equals to N upon M. A to C, that is N, and B to C, that is M. Okay. Now, this implies that AC vector upon BC vector is equals to N upon M. Now, AC vector means position vector of C minus position vector of A divided by position vector of C minus position vector of B, and this is equals to N upon M. Now we will solve this ratio, this proportional ratio, and we'll find the coordinate of C and we'll find the position vector of C. Okay, so N into C vector minus A vector is equals to N into C vector minus B vector. Okay, so this is equals to N C vector minus N A vector is equals to N C vector minus N B vector. Okay, now we want to find the position vector of C, that is C vector. Okay, so transfer the terms like this: N C vector minus N C vector equals to N A vector minus N B vector. Okay, now taking C vector as common, M minus N C vector is equals to N A vector minus N B vector, and this implies that C vector is equals to N A vector minus N B vector divided by M minus N. Okay, so this is the position vector of any point C. C that is outside the line segment. C, that point lie outside the line segment, and position vector of that point C is equals to N A vector minus N B vector and minus N. Okay, means this will treated as the formula for finding the position vector of any point lies outside the line segment, that is N A vector minus N B vector divided by N minus N. Okay, so this is all about the external section or external division. Okay, now we can discuss the coordinate of midpoint means the point lying on the line segment at the midpoint. The coordinate of point or the position vector of the midpoint. Position vector of a midpoint. Okay, let us suppose that AB is any line segment. AB is any line segment. C is the point lying in the middle of A and B. Lying in the middle of A and B means C is dividing the line segment in the ratio 1:1. C is dividing the line segment in the ratio 1:1. That is N equals to 1 and N equals to 1. Now let us suppose that O is the position vector of origin. So with respect to O, the position पोजीशन वेक्टर ऑफ ए ए वेक्टर, पोजीशन वेक्टर ऑफ बी बी वेक्टर, पोजीशन वेक्टर ऑफ सी सी वेक्टर। ओके सो नाउ नाउ एसी अपॉन एबी, एसी अपॉन एबी इज इक्वल्स टू 1/1, एसी इक्वल्स टू एबी, एसी दैट इज सी वेक्टर माइनस ए वेक्टर इज इक्वल्स टू एबी दैट इज ए वेक्टर माइनस बी वेक्टर। ओके दिस वन इज रॉन्ग, एसी वेक्टर अपॉन सीबी वेक्टर इज इक्वल्स टू 1/1, एसी वेक्टर मीन सी वेक्टर माइनस ए वेक्टर अपॉन बी वेक्टर माइनस बी वेक्टर माइनस सी वेक्टर दैट इज 1/1। सो सी वेक्टर माइनस ए वेक्टर इक्वल्स टू बी वेक्टर माइनस सी वेक्टर मीन सी वेक्टर प्लस सी वेक्टर इक्वल्स टू ए वेक्टर प्लस बी वेक्टर। सो 2c वेक्टर इज इक्वल्स टू ए वेक्टर प्लस बी वेक्टर। सो सी वेक्टर इक्वल्स टू ए वेक्टर प्लस बी वेक्टर डिवाइडेड बाय 2। ओके इफ सी इज द मिडिल पॉइंट, if c is the midpoint of line segment ab then its position vector c vector will be given c vector equals to a vector plus b vector divided by 2। okay so this is all about the vector addition and property of vector addition, property of scalar multiplication as well as the section formula that is internal section formula, external section formula। ओके थैंक यू।